name or company, it's every occupant in the apartment.
I agree, but.
So that will get us a step closer.
Is one apartment for 27 people? You tell me.
What about the fire?
It is 27 people.
That's what we're trying to get.
How many was it?
I don't know the exact number.
I counted them.
I.
Is it over 20?
I just believe it was over, maybe about, I don't know.
I saw the flash. It's over 20 for sure.
Hey, whoa, whoa.
Mark, conversation up here.
Okay.
Is this year round? I just want to ask you one thing. Is it year round or?
I don't know what their lease is.
We'll definitely.
But the point is you can either have a hotel, you can have a boarding house.
We'll look into it.
Or you can have an apartment, you know, but the point is, it just doesn't seem right that, you know, you guys got to fight your ordinances. You put them in place. If it costs you $18,000 to fight that other one, then use the money. If you have no backbone, you shouldn't be up there.
Yeah.
Right.
I have one question on that.
I live on Court Street, and the upper part of Court Street has not been cleaned almost all summer, mainly because we have people that refuse to move their cars. The first part of the summer, they were ticketed. Now, all of a sudden, nobody's getting tickets. They drive nice Cadillacs, and the street cleaner cannot get down. Our street is a mess. Is there something that you can do after they won't move their cars a certain number of times?
How do you know they're not getting tickets?
Because we go out early in the morning when we go to work, and there's no tickets on them.
Court Street.
Yeah. Usually the police stick them in the side, by the side mirror in the window, and there wasn't even any under the windshield wipers either.
It's from 11th Street to where it turns on to the.
It's out onto Market Street. And the street is a mess. It is a mess. And the street cleaner can't get down. You can hear him coming, and he comes in, and then he has to back out because none of them have moved their cars. And it's, you know, it's about two or three houses that they don't move their cars.
So you knew we went to clean that street?
Yeah, we can't get down there.
Yeah, you can't get down.
We're keeping it a secret.
It's even.
Police department didn't tell us, or?
I didn't know they weren't ticketing until she, I don't live at the police station.
Okay. Well, I guess we don't street clean right now, but that's beside the point. Somebody else in the back? Yes, sir.
I have a comment or a question. I've noticed today, Packer Street from Bimbo out to Front Street is where most of the tractor trailers are running. Now they're running Joy Street. Joy Street is not wide enough for tractor trailers and cars. Just is not. Why they're using it all of a sudden, I don't know. But I counted 12 trucks today coming in and out of there. With a school bus and any car, you have to block the intersection. I don't think that's the way we want to run that.
What truck?
It's just not wide enough.
From the Bimbo facility?
Yeah, why they're coming out of there all of a sudden, I don't know.
Are they blacktopping their entrance? Going through the Celotex site?
They're going through the site that Moran owns.
Well, I still call it Celotex.
Yeah. They've got the gates open now.
Well, actually, for years, that's how they got in and out of Celotex.
Yeah, Dave.
That was Celotex. That's not Bimbo.
Yeah, I know, but there still was tractor trailers.
But you've got more cars there now than you've had before. They're parked on both sides. You cannot get through.
Dave, they're paving the parking lot on the Packard side.
Oh, wait, well, what about Packard Street itself? When's that going to get taken care of? That's a mess. Again, always.
We have $600,000 from the liquid fuels in the street and that Chester Street project.
I understand.
If they let it go, maybe next year Chris can get the street done. But we got $662,000 to be exactly the Chester Street.
Well, I know I mentioned to you a couple of weeks ago about the railroad crossing there that has been abandoned for years.
Yep.
It is now rotting out. The railroad ties are rotting out. It's just a hazard. Can they do anything with that?
That
it's not
Dave,
used.
The guy, Dave, remember that time I told you, I don't know if I gave you the extra card, but I called up to message for the guy from the railroad. He hasn't returned my call. And that's the hardest problem.
Moran was trying to buy that off of them, but I think that fell through. The railroad didn't want to give it up.
No, I think Moran broke it off.
Did he buy it?
Who's the person that's supposed to be maintaining that? Would that be Moran?
I don't know.
No, not on Packer Street. either Woodward Center or City.
I mean, the thing is not used at all.
Not railroad crossing.
Has not been used in probably 30 years.
We don't touch railroad.
You're talking like next to the old John York.
It's on the street, right? About the old John York, the railroad crossing there, that's rotting out.
It's not.
That's because they don't use it.
It's either who owns it.
North Coast.
Yeah, I don't know who owns it. But I did call Dave.
I'm not sure who owns that.
Left, and the guy was a real estate guy that came up and talked to us, and I still haven't done any of that.
Well, the problem we had today with the traffic control is they're not stopping the stop signs.
Well, that's about the fourth thing you're on, how you're not, your time's up. Somebody in the back corner, our key, yes?
I just wanted to respond to the concerns that Mr. Wahlberg brought up. He and I both have volunteered a lot overtime in the city. We both have a lot of vested interest in the city. And I had to, and it was myself that took the case in the variance for 202 Arch Street. That property, although I do know that that was part of those sale guidelines about the change of the property, of not wanting to use it anymore for apartments, it actually had been apartments previously for decades, 5 apartments in that building, that is how it was designed. At the time, whenever the changes were made, there wasn't parking available. However, due to changes in the neighborhood, the minimum available parking close to that property is 27 stalls. I only needed 8 on any particular time for those rental permits for that building. My business partner and I did not create the hardship at that location. You know, over the past 2 centuries, everything was built up, property sold off, and there's no parking on that property. We tried not for a couple months, not for a year. We tried for 10 years for another use for that property. So I would appreciate if the city did not try to change the overturn the judge's decision in that case. I think it is completely valid. And I hope to actually see some use and life in that building instead of having sitting there as a blighted property, diagonal from the prison, you know, which hopefully we can have something beautiful there in the near future too. In regards to the downtown, yes, I do have an apartment in downtown, second and third floor of a building downtown, and there are multiple people in it that are not related. That does not violate code. There are no code violations in that property. And I have to say, in general, second floor uses in our downtown is a huge issue. It's a huge issue that we can't use these second floors, or we're very, very limited in what these second floors can be used for. So I think we need to get together and try and find solutions for how we can improve the downtown by finding good uses for that and ways to allow use of those second floors.
Well,
it's not a question and answer.
I just want to make the public aware that when those tenants were there, we had a lot of grass or trash out in front that my department was picking up.
Mm-hmm.
They cost the city money, and whoever was there were very filthy people.
Mm-hmm.
Because of all the trash. I mean, we don't haul people's personal trash, but they were putting it out by the reserver outlet there. And let me tell you, it cost the city a little bit of money to do that.
Yeah.
I think we should be able to bill for that.
Yeah.
I believe, however, that was a short-term issue. We made sure it got taken care of.
Okay. Thank you. Anybody else?
Well, I just have one quick thing.
Yep.
On this code, with multiple people around, let's say most of them typically work during the day, and the code office goes there, and there's only one person there. They report one person. But I know up on 12th Street, there's an issue with 2 properties up there, maybe 3.
Yeah.
Is there any way the code office would consider, like, part-time, full-time, having them come in the evenings, knock on the door, and then you'll find out how many people are in there. So that's the problem. If Mike goes during the day, if they're all working, there's nobody there, right, Mike? But if you go at night...
We got photos and IDs of everybody that's living here, if there's other people living here.
I can tell you right now, up in 12th Street, I've been up there 3 different times, and all those people that are staying in that property is not listed. So don't tell me you do. We have an issue.
Right.
If anything, can we have code office people go out at nighttime?
That's another thing with the nuisance property task force that I want to try to address is that very issue. Because when we cooperate and we share information, we may go there for a police call and identify people, and if the police department, the codes department are communicating,
and we say, hey, we went there for a call at a rental property, and we encountered this person and this person, and he doesn't have them in their file, then we know that somebody obviously...
Thank you.
You know, it's, we call it in you know, pretty much the drawer rule. If somebody's, you know, got clothes in the drawer, they're living there, so... Okay.
Dave, what I gotta say, aren't you, we're on the sweeper until the 17th?
Well, we're supposed to make an announcement tonight. It actually broke today, so we suspended the sweeper for this week. I talked to Captain Bennett today. We're issuing no tickets for the rest of the week. Actually, because we were going out and starting getting leaves today, and something broke on it. Until we get it fixed, if it takes a day or two. If we get them called off, courts off, cars off of Court Street, I promise you, I'll set it up during the day and we'll get it cleaned.
Good luck moving them.
That's what I was going to say, Dale. Maybe catch up.
I have a note here that says you're not doing it. So you're a street sweeper, aren't you?
What's that?
I have a note here that says you're not doing it anymore.
No, no more. It was only going to be this week. It broke down today. But like I said, if we can somehow get the cars off that section of court, I'll set the sweeper up. But now, keep in mind, when it gets close to 30 and 40, we don't send it out because it freezes.
Late night shoppers, December 7th. Santa Parade, Friday, November 24th, 6:30 p.m. Anybody know where that actually starts? High school?
Raspberry Avenue.
Raspberry Avenue. All right, then the Santa House has hours. Tearing down the stairs of the Santa House. Thank you everybody for coming. This meeting is adjourned.
$200,000 in the
parking lot.